Hey, yo, what is up, everybody? Chuck here, and welcome to a live commentary. Now, if you're not familiar with this series, basically what I do is I hop on Call of Duty. Normally when I do this, I play All or Nothing on Modern Warfare 3. Obviously, I'm waiting for that to come out on Infinite Warfare in a public match. It's currently available in private matches, but it's not fun to play against bots or to do private matches. I mean, they're fun, but not fun to commentate because it's, I don't know, it's weird. So I'm waiting for that, but this is the game that I've been enjoying when it comes to Call of Duty. This is the first game I ever started playing when I first got my Xbox. It was this one in GTA 4, I believe it was. I was 16. So we're going to play some Modern Warfare Remastered. I'm a sniper on this game. I snipe. I don't have much else unlocked. I've got the Barrett, just unlocked that, but it seems slower than usual. So I haven't been using it much. We got the gold on the M40. And I miss doing these. I really do miss it. Let's do domination. I'm going to turn the TV down, make sure we don't have an echo. Please give me fucking vacant. Please give me vacant. Now, I can tell these people are... Everybody votes vacant. Okay. Well, they vote ambush. Never mind. But I miss doing these. I really do. And a lot of you guys have subbed for Call of Duty. You know, I've had this channel for five and a half years now. Almost exactly 5.5 years. And... you know, a lot of you guys are here because you want to watch Call of Duty, and I understand that. But if you think about just the sequence of the past couple years with my channel and with Call of Duty, that lobby doesn't look like it's ever going to start. You know, Call of Duty games, so it went Ghost, which I'm going to rate about a 3 out of 10. Advanced Warfare, which I don't know if I liked more than Ghost. I was awful at it. But I was also bad at Ghost. And that's normally how I judge a game... from being good to bad. Like, my worst Call of Duty games are the ones that, ironically, I liked the least. And I don't know which one comes first. Do you not like a game and then that's why you start playing bad? Or do you start playing awful and that's why you don't like it? I was bad at Black Ops 1. I didn't like that game. I liked Zombies, the OG Kino. But, I mean, Ghost wasn't great. Advanced Warfare wasn't great. Black Ops 3 was fun. You know, it gave me... I probably played the game until about March. It gave me about four-ish months of content, which is great. But it was the Dark Matter grind. That's really what kept me going on that game. Hopefully I'll snipe well today. I had a couple good games yesterday. Fuck. I used to be a really good sniper. And I say that every time I start playing these classic games. Like Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 3, COD 4... I mean, I was a good sniper. I could do it. I could hold my own. I can't see that, but I got that kill. Let's fucking go. I'm dead. I didn't get a collat, did I? No. I got the dome shot on him across the map. But, like, I started... The reason I even started doing YouTube was actually... It was my first account. And I started doing sniping montages. And I would have, like, my friend's older brother edit them because I was like, how old would I have been? 15, I would have been 15, 16 years old. No, I was older than that because I didn't have an Xbox. I was like probably 17. Mostly 17. I didn't know how to edit videos. I was a lazy ass. I made this YouTube account and, you know, I had like 5,000 subscribers in my first ever YouTube and I was like, holy shit, I'm famous. I mean, this is... You get your older brother to edit for me. He's going to do it for free. Because I'm famous, okay? I got 5K subs. I'm partnered with Machinima or whatever I was partnered. I don't think I was actually partnered with Machinima now that I think about it. I may have been. I just don't remember. Because now partnerships don't even matter on YouTube, but that's a whole different topic. So I used to snipe, make montages, have people edit for me, and they weren't good edits. I mean, they were awful. It was Movie Maker type shit. And you guys know that that's not the best editing software in the world, but, you know, it got the job done, and, you know, I got pretty decent at sniping back in the day, so, hopefully you guys will see a little glimpse of that, okay, fucking, fuck you. I do use Martyrdom, and I'm also a very vocal anti-Martyrdom user, like, I hate people who use it, but the reason I started using it in this game is because... When I play, there are certain maps, and I can kind of tell who the new people on COD 4 are, Modern Warfare Remastered, whatever you want to call it. I'll probably call it COD 4. But you can tell who the new people are, because most people who know this game and played it when it was first out and first popular, they know the map. So they don't feel the need to camp in corners. They kind of know where people are going to be. So I used Martyrdom to counter that. Like I Bacon especially. Bacon and Shipment. The amount of times they got killed by This dude. You think I can get him with this? You think I can get him? Oh my god, I'm too good. There's another one over here though. I think he was shooting. Please tell me there's another one. No. You coming back? Oh, you did. So, back to what I was talking about. Used to make sniping montages, blah, 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 blah. They weren't good. I don't claim that they were good, but I could snipe. I just couldn't edit. And, yeah. But I've missed doing these. Like, I used to do them knifing and stuff and all or nothing. I hate Jug. Absolutely despise it. We're in a 2v5. Alright, I won't do a 2v5. I won't do that shit. Even though that's one of my favorite maps, there's no reason for me to suffer through that. But a lot of you guys are probably aware, and I feel like we need to have this talk, because there's probably 50,000 or so people, maybe more than that, maybe 60,000 people who are subbed for Pokemon Go. And that's awesome. And that does really well on my channel, and people, you know, I have people tweeting me, they're like, I missed the COD videos. Well, I uploaded some COD videos when the beta was out. And, you know, they weren't the greatest videos, but they were interesting, and they were something that had they been uploaded 3 years ago to my channel, they would have done really well. So, that could mean, A, all the people who watch COD on my channel have passed away. And there's, I've actually done this math. Oh. Okay, that's a nice lag. That's sweet. So we're not gonna stay in here either. I actually did the math, and just judging, I don't even know how I did it, but I did some math, it was probably like last summer, to figure out how many people who are sub to me have died. You know, just playing the numbers game, you know, I've got 600,000 people here. I think I came to the conclusion that about 180 have probably died, given the average viewer age. And mortality rate for that age is how I calculated it. So we have 180 dead subs, literally dead subs. So rest in peace to them. Very much appreciated that they ever stopped by and watched a couple videos. But, oh, look at that nice dub. Oh, look at that trip. What the, how many, what, did I, how did I already have an airstrike? Jesus fuck almighty. All right, let's go over here. So we have dead, there are literally dead subscribers, and then there's, figuratively dead people who don't watch YouTube that subscribed a couple years ago. And that's a large portion of those people sub for Call of Duty videos. So people always use the argument against me. Hey Chuck, you have so many people who are subbed for you for Call of Duty and yet you upload Pokemon Go. Well, number one, if we're being honest here, not only does Pokemon Go do much better on my channel than Call of Duty does, that's proof. Go back and watch the Black Ops 3 video, see how they did compared to Pokemon Go videos. But I still play Pokemon Go every single day. I play Pokemon Go every day. So people are always like, Chuck, it's a dead game. Nobody plays it. No, the people who stop playing it are the people who... first things first, let's clear this up. Pokemon was basically the game of my childhood. Whether it was the trading cards, the card games, the Game Boy games. I had a green Game Boy Color. I'm getting my ass kicked right now. I had a green Game Boy Color. Red, yellow, blue were my first three. Then I had gold and silver. Eat a dick. And that was my childhood. So I played that game. And that's why I love this part, is because I'm always so turned off by Pokemon because of how many new Pokemon there are. But in Pokemon Go right now, there's only the 150 or 142 that you can get in each region, which is like comforting to me, because I can go back, relive part of my childhood, and not have to worry about the extra 700 Pokemon. Now, eventually, I'm sure they'll release them into Pokemon Go, but who knows when that'll be. So for now, I'm gonna enjoy the shit out of it. You're dead. So yes, I still play it, and there are people who play it. There's plenty of people who play it. The people who stop playing it are ones who, A, never started, you know, they never played it in their childhood, so they just kind of, you know, picked up the fad. They had never played Pokemon, touched Pokemon, heard of it, yes, but probably couldn't name more than 8. Charmander, Squirtle, Pikachu, Snorlax, whatever. But there's plenty of people who still play it. So all the people, whenever I get these comments, it's normally high schoolers. So no offense, most of you guys are in high school. Get out of my way. And at that age, now again, no offense, but at that age in high school, you tend to think that your opinion, your values represent the majority. And newsflash, how am I even 10 and 10? I was playing like shit. Newsflash, it does not represent the majority. So, yes, do people still play it? Yes, I'm going to keep uploading it. You're damn right. I can't wait for Generation 2 of Pokemon Go. But I feel guilty not uploading Call of Duty. And because what it's come down to now is I make Pokemon Go videos and I stream Call of Duty. So if you don't follow me on Twitch, you should do so. I stream Call of Duty probably 4 times a week. I originally was playing a lot of Infinite Warfare. I was grinding for the Black Sky camo, and then saw that they updated the camo, and it looks even worse now, which basically killed my desire to play that game. So, I play mainly this game. Sometimes I'm good, most of the time I'm bad. But it's always a good time. Like last night, I'll probably actually upload this eventually as like a mini clip. I had to eat 2 ghost peppers on my stream. And if you're not familiar, there's a bunch of like little peppers that nobody's ever heard of. But I think it's like the 6th most hot pepper in the world, or 6th hottest pepper in the world. Over 1 million Scoville units, which is how they measure it. By comparison, a habanero pepper is 100,000 Scoville units, and a jalapeno is 5,000. So if you think jalapenos are hot, this was very hot. I ate like dried ones, and I had 2 of them. And you know, it wasn't awful. I thought it was going to be way worse, but I think part of the reason it wasn't that bad is because I didn't chew very much. I kind of just took a couple bites to like to lube it up to get down my throat, and just swallowed it. And my stomach didn't even start hurting until probably like 5 hours after the fact. So last night, I turned my toilet into Flint drinking water. You guys probably don't get that joke. Dirty. It was dirty. My toilet was definitely dirty. So that happened on stream last night. It's always a fun time. So if you don't follow me, do it. I hate Juggernaut so much. Eat a dick. I could have so many good clips on this game. I'm not kidding. I've had so many clips ruined by Juggernaut, which means I've had no usable clips. I do have a couple, actually, but they aren't like 5-man feeds or anything crazy like that. It's like I get a triple feed, and then like somebody fucks it up and splits the feed, and then I get another triple or something like that. Depends on the map. I have to get in a good position. Like, there we go. Double martyrdom kill montage, baby! And also, speaking of COD, nice grenade, Chuck. Speaking of COD, you know, I'm waiting on All or Nothing to come back. Let's have a little discussion about this. There's some other topics I want to talk about that aren't COD related. I hate knifing on this game. Only use me blade. Props to you, man, because knifing on this game it doesn't make any goddamn sense. So the fact that this is the game that made you passionate about it, holy fuck ass. Couldn't do it. Anyway. So a couple months ago, not a couple months ago, it was probably about 2 weeks before COD release. So that would have been towards the end of October. So about a month ago, Activision, some of the Infinity Ward designers leaked some intel. I'm trying to do air quotes, but I'm playing a video game, so it's hard to do. They leaked some intel on their Twitter, and it was basically a screenshot showcasing that All or Nothing was going to be returning to Infinite Warfare. Now, obviously, that's something that gets me really excited, because that was like, when I think back, that's what made my channel take off. I did a bunch of really cool throwing knife tutorials and stuff like that, and those will come back. As soon as All or Nothing is brought back into public matches, I hate that shit. There will be a surge of Call of Duty content, and I'm not going to stop with Pokemon Go. So if you are here right now watching and you're like, thank God he's never going to upload that again, you better just leave, because you're not going to be happy. I'm going to try and achieve like a 60-40 split or a 50-50. Basically keep the Pokemon Go uploads, but then also add in 2 or 3 COD videos a week, which, if you think about it, you think back to the last couple years of my channel, that's really all I've uploaded for COD anyway. A couple times a week. Oh, the no-scope! Did you hear him? He's not happy with me.
Completely blind.
Oh, man. You know what we're going to have to make? We're going to have to make a say what? We're going to have to make a say what? What's that dude's name? What is that dude's name? Oh, it's the dude. He's 1-2 on that team. He just got no-scoped. His first death of the game. I feel bad for him. I'm going to keep the Pokemon Go, of course. But I'm going to try and work in some more Call of Duty because I know I feel like I'm kind of cheating you guys out. And really, like, the people who complain... the people who I see complain the most... Who uses claymores? That one douchebag who I fucking no-scoped uses the claymore. So that... Don't even try it. You know what? I got 3 grenades. I'm using them. Uh-oh, you trying to do it again? You want to get no-scoped again? UAV recon, sending... Oh-ho-ho-ho! Wrong guy. But I'm still better than everybody. Oh, fuck, where is... Oh, he must be camping with his claymores back there. So I've been waiting for, like, an opportunity to play... Or to make more Call of Duty videos. I really have. I'm being completely honest here. So when this game came out, I was like, okay, you know, trolling on this game's hard because it's such a bare bones game. It's really basic. You've got the 357 and I normally take advantage of an exploit like kill streaks and stuff like that for trolling. But there isn't much of that in this game. So this was a game I was like, okay, oh, fuck my ass. A lot of people who played the original are going to be talking with their mics. It's a nostalgic thing. You know, there's going to be a lot of communication. Lobbies are going to be loud. That didn't happen. Sometimes you get into lobbies with 1 or 2 people talking. God, I really miss this game. But never like it was back in the day. Like, people just don't talk. So, say what episodes, I would love to make them. I love subtitling videos. It is a pain in the ass to do if you don't edit videos. Let me tell you, subtitling, when you literally have to change... word by word, full conversations for 3-4 minute videos. Oh my god, pain in the ass. But I love doing it. It's exciting. It allows me to like express creativity, whatever. So those will come back. I have to basically like dedicate full days to do that. And that's hard for me to do at this point. It was easier for me to do back in the day when I didn't have like a successful backbone. Like Black Ops 3, there wasn't anything on my channel that was like killing it. I had good videos, they were decent, but I never took off in Black Ops 3. So it was easier for me to like work on say what's or whatever, and I didn't do that many. And same thing with Advanced Warfare and even back into Ghosts. I think I went back to Black Ops 2 actually after playing Ghosts for a couple months, but... So those will come back. And you know, when they bring... All or Nothing to Infinite Warfare public matches, I will be working on some FSCs. I made some really cool montages on Black Ops 3, by the way. So if you ever missed those, go back and watch them, because I think they're my best montages since, like, the mid-FSU days. Like, since, like, I think episode probably, like, 5 is probably when I, like, started hitting my peak on All or Nothing. Then I did another, like, 60 episodes or whatever. My Black Ops 3 montage is really cool. So go check those out. But definitely gonna be playing some All or Nothing, you know, as long as they bring it out. Who knows? It's already been 3 weeks, and I was under the impression that it was gonna be in a public match right when it came out. So, I mean, it could be another month. Maybe it'll be a Christmas update. God forbid. Well, actually, playing All or Nothing against a bunch of Christmas noobs would be ideal. But ideal? I sound like Freeland. I will be playing with Freeland, by the way. Freeland will be making a return. I believe he made a video, actually, that said he was returning to YouTube. Doubt he's uploaded. He's probably waiting on the same thing I am. All or Nothing. So anyway, you know, don't think that I forget about Call of Duty. And I was trying to get to this earlier. There's a very vocal minority. Most people are happy that my channel has done well recently. And they're like, you know what? Keep doing you. Keep doing you. Keep doing well. I can tell that this is good for your channel, But then there's also I've got selfish high school age kids. No offense, guys. I'm sorry, but that's just how you are. Believe me, I was there. I was a selfish high school kid at one point. They think that I'm abandoning them. And it's not like they watch all my videos anyway. But they just want to be able to. They want to like just fight. They want to just argue. So. You should be dead. Fuck you. There's no way that didn't kill you. Anyway. So I don't think I'm abandoning you. The videos will come. You know, this is the most I've uploaded, the most regularly I've uploaded in a while. So if you like me as a person and not just for the game I play, you probably have been enjoying the past couple months. So thank you, everybody. A quick thank you to everybody who subbed for Pokemon and is watching this, everybody who's been subbed for Call of Duty for the past fucking 5 years, and you're watching this and you're like, thank God, let me get myself a can of Whippets and a bag of Funyuns and enjoy this. Well, welcome. Welcome to the club. I don't do Whippets. That was a joke. Somebody brought that up in my stream last night because I was trying to put whipped cream in my mouth after doing the ghost peppers and it wasn't working. And it looked like I was just huffing out of the ready whip. So anyway, but let's talk about some non-YouTube-y things, because that's why I love doing the, look at that bitch, that's why I love doing these videos, is because I can talk about anything. I shouldn't have to talk about YouTube and explain myself. If you like the content, you stay. If you don't like it, you leave. And I think sometimes I feel like I need to remind people that, which is kind of sad. Like, you'd think that'd be self-explanatory. Anyway, Black Friday, let's talk about Black Friday. So that was what? That was 2 days ago, and, you know, growing up, and even just a couple years ago, Black Friday was always like, holy shit, can't wait to get a sweet deal on a TV that I probably don't need, or earbuds. Like, I'm thinking back a couple years, probably 4 years ago, I bought myself a pair of Diamond Tears headphones, which were really dope. They were really cool looking. They were like shiny purple with like a jewel in them. Or something. I don't know what they were. But I had those. I bought those on a Black Friday deal. They were like $100 off or something. A complete waste of money, obviously. That's what you do on Black Friday. I also bought a tablet. And it was when the tablet craze was kind of taking off. 4 years ago sounds about right. So I bought one to have one. I didn't want to splurge on an iPad or anything because I didn't like Apple products. I didn't have an iPhone at that time. Shit, I want to focus and start playing well. Ah, damn it! Every game I do on the top of my, I finish well, but I just feel like I need to get some clips for you guys. And I can, I'm capable, just fucking wait. So I used to waste so much money on like electronics and stuff, and you'll quickly realize, the older you get, that electronics are a strange purchase, because especially someone like me, I kind of need. Fuck these guys. I hope they fucking all die. Let's use the Barrett. I haven't used that yet today. I might leave this lobby. I want to get a little bit of shipment. I want to get a full game on Bog and Vacant. That would be fucking awesome. Thank God. That's why I love this gun. And you quickly realize that making these large electronics purchases... Fam, mind your way? It is such a waste on Black Friday, especially the TVs. If you guys didn't know, when you buy TVs on Black Friday, I'm going to leave this lobby. I'm sorry you guys hate me. Gameplay has been subpar today. I'm going to make it up for you right here. We're going to get quads, only quads. But like they make TVs under a different model name. And what they do is they basically like make them shittier. They make them cheaper plastic, less HDMI ports, no USB ports in the back, whatever it may be, to shave off their production costs and therefore sell it for cheaper. So you get you think you're getting this sweet 55-inch 4K smart TV, but really you're getting like the Goodwill version of the Walmart version. You're getting a little gypped. People get tripped into it, and I used to get tricked into that stuff. But like even stuff like I'll play back a lot. Even stuff like headphones. what's cool 1 year isn't cool the next year. When Beats first came out, every fucking person had Beats. Now nobody gives a shit. Now if I see somebody walking around with Beats, I'm like, those must be 8 years old because nobody's bought them in 8 years. So what are you doing? So this Black Friday, I was trying to get this across, that I no longer get excited about electronics on Black Friday. If there's something I need for like my setup, like right now, the two things I'm looking for. So if anybody has any recommendations here, help me out. Two things I'm looking for. First off, I need some better lighting because it's winter. And any of you guys who make videos or film or stream or whatever know that the winter is hard. It is. Why am I playing against people who scuff jump in fucking Modern Warfare Remastered? Put your fucking scuff away, please. Do the world a favor and walk off a curb. Give me ball. Oh, Jesus Christ. I'll play Ambush again. God damn it. So now, for Black Friday, like today, or not today, this weekend, we actually went shopping on Thursday. It was just Sarah and I for Thanksgiving. Her family, the only family that she had in this state, went on a cruise to somewhere, Mexico or something. So it was literally in the state, it was just us. It was me and Sarah. My family is nowhere near us. It's in Wisconsin. And then literally my entire family's in Wisconsin. And then I have two sisters, one moved to LA and one moved to Florida. So they're in good places for like family trips, family vacations, stuff like that. But I wouldn't want to celebrate, and no offense, because I'm sure probably like 20% of you live in California or Florida or some warm area, but I couldn't celebrate a Christmas in a warm area. I want snow. I want painful fucking weather. You know, I want it to feel Christmassy, and it doesn't feel Christmassy if it... Where is this guy? So it was just us two for Thanksgiving, so we were like, okay, we're done eating. Let's go shop. So we did Walmart, we did Target, we did Best Buy. Did we do Best Buy? We did Best Buy, we did Macy's, we did... Did we do Macy's? I don't even remember at this point. I think we did do Macy's, though, yes. God, it's so hard to talk. I have to get back into this. The whole talking and playing at the same time. I think that's why my AON live comms were always so quiet. And I talk so sparingly in those because it's hard to play well and talk at the same time. So going to all those stores, all I walked away with on Black Friday was a winter coat and two sweaters. Oh no, and we bought Sharpies too. We bought a big pack of Sharpies because that's what adults get excited about. Well, maybe Sarah and I aren't adults, and that's why we like it. But anyway, it's weird how your tastes change so quickly. Like, even just 2 years ago, I would have never gone Black Friday shopping and been like, oh, thank God that sweater's on sale. And now, here I am at 24, buying sweaters on Black Friday. It's just... I'm so sick of joining lobby. Can I get into a lobby that hasn't fucking started the game? Please, for the love of God. There should be an option. Why is there no option to just join a lobby that isn't in progress? Thank you. I must have somehow set off. I want to play Bog. Let's go, baby. Let's go. So Black Friday used to be so dope, and it's still cool. Like, I like going out on Black Friday and just watching the I like being around people, but I don't like talking to people. Maybe I'm the only one who's like that, but like, I remember back in like college and stuff, like I didn't have like 800 friends to go hang out with. So if like my selection of friends, there were probably like 8 people, whatever, 10 people. If they were all occupied, you know, I would want to go be somewhere where people are, but not have to talk to them. That was my thing. Fuck you. I was moving. And I don't know what it is. You like being a part of something, but I don't necessarily like talking to random people. I'm just not about that. I'm probably an introvert. If there was a cut and dry black line between the two, I probably lean more towards the introvert side, but some people might not believe, but it's true. You know, I don't make conversation with everybody I see. Some people do. I would like more people to kill. Ah, you little bitch. But I like just, on Black Friday, I like just being out there and seeing everything, and there's Christmas music, and I'm already jamming out. So if you guys like Christmas music, on my live streams, I'm already jamming out to it. So even if you just want to come listen to a really good playlist of Christmas music, I got you. Seriously. Are we against the... Oh my... Every time I get into a 6v3. Thank you. Really? Bitch. Oh! Oh! What the fuck? Man, put that in the montage, please. So even though I don't like... Like, the best deals on Black Friday, supposedly, are... You know, the TVs. Or... we were trying to get a 3DS. Sarah wants a 3DS. She wants to play Animal Crossing. I never played Animal Crossing. I don't know what console that originally came out on. But I never played it growing up or as a high schooler or in college or whenever I was supposed to play it. But she wants a 3DS for that. So we were looking for like the $100 off 3DS and couldn't find it. Literally sold out everywhere, and we were out shopping by like 7 o'clock and it was gone. So that was like our electronic. We were seeking out for that. Couldn't find it. But it's still, I like being around people. And there's, like, every year it gets harder and harder to make a Christmas list. Because the older you get, the more you realize that it's like weird to ask other people to buy you things. Because at my age, if I was really like... Yeah, I don't even know how to word it, but... I'm sure some of you can relate, like, it becomes more important to spend time with family or close people to you than it is to receive things. Like, I don't really, in fact, I find receiving presents sometimes to be really awkward. Not because you don't like the presents, but because, like, how do you show the appropriate amount of thankfulness? Do I, oh my god, thank you. Like, I can't do that. I also can't feign enthusiasm over something I'm not excited about. So, like, back in the day, like, once I hit college, that was when, like, my presents started getting really shitty from, like, extended family members. Like, there was one time, it was early college, might have been actually late high school. My grandparents, which, God forbid, they're watching my videos, they're probably not, but sorry. They thought I was really into birds. Now, I do like birds. I find birds to be fascinating. Like, if I see a bald eagle... Or a hawk flying, I'll point them out and I'll be like, hey Sarah, look at that. Because they're beautiful. I mean, there's some beautiful... Fuck you! You're not beautiful. Eat a dick. But they thought I was super into it, and my grandpa was really into it. So this Christmas, I want to say I was probably 17. They gave me a used book about birds. About bird spotting. And I was just... I had to pretend that I gave a fuck. And I think that's where, like, I don't... That's where my whole awkward Christmas, like, how do you thank somebody for something that you don't... That you know they spent money on, that you don't care about. Like, how do you do that? How do you thank somebody for that? And I think that's where it started. Oh, I should have got that. No, scoop! Chuck, you bitch! Now, even though that was really quick, those three kills were super quick. My speed was split, I think, three times. That's not fair. The only way you can get feeds is by fucking using helicopters on shipment. Oh, Lord. Why were you behind me? So Christmas gets weird. Now at this age, it doesn't get weird because it's just me and Sarah. I don't have to deal with extended family buying me... Fuck, I can't. I'm trying to think of weird gifts. You know, your grandparents always buy you, like, sweaters or something that are way too big. But at Kohl's, they had a damn good deal, so your grandma's gonna get you a sweater. And you may get three. All the same color and three different sizes because they were on sale. And they wanted their Kohl's cash. You know, and that's what is awkward. So, like, although I would also get good presents, like, it's still, like, that. I don't like when things are awkward. It, like, bothers me. Some people are like, OMG, I'm awkward. LOL, smiley face. Yeah, you're fucking awkward. But if it doesn't bother you, then it's no big deal. And some awkward things bother me. Awkward situations suck. Yeah. So Christmas is it's coming. It's coming quick. It seems like it was literally a week ago it was Halloween. And apparently that was not a week ago. Apparently this guy is laying down. Oh, eat a dick. Oh, somebody just got a triple headshot feed. Good work. Good work, mate. Okay, leg, sweet. So if you guys want to see more of these, now there are some people who are going to enjoy them and some people who are going to be like, Chuck, yo, next top five sightings, where the fuck is it? It's been like fucking 4 days. Are you even alive? Yes, I'm alive. I'm still alive. And it'll probably be out tomorrow. Anyway, so if you guys want to see more of these, live commentary, mainly it'll be on here. If you guys want to like pick a game mode for me to play, domination and sniping is like my easiest, my go-to, you know, like if I want to make something look slightly entertaining, I'll play this game mode and snipe. But if you guys want to watch me like play search with a full party of viewers or something like that, I can do that. This lag is sweet. I love when that happens. When I'm aimed in right at somebody, and then all of a sudden they do the cha-cha slide and they're 8 feet away. Fuck you. You got dicked. You got absolutely dickeronied. Dickeronied. Kill him for me. Jesus. Young Braemar, useless teammate. So if you want more, let me know below. And if you have any suggestions for changes, let me know. If you just enjoy this and you're like super happy that this came out, you can leave a like, because some people think, number one, can I clear up this misconception? I can't believe people still believe this. So some people, I've had people who are like, Chuck, the only reason you ask for likes is because you make money based on how many likes you get. No! What? Where the fuck did you hear that? Then I would like bot every fucking video I have. No, that's stupid. Don't believe that. Really what it does is if a video does well, so this is apparently, you also see a lot of YouTubers who complain about algorithms and stuff like that. However, I don't know how to word this without being mean. YouTube's never been perfect. So to sit there and be like, oh, something switched 2 months ago and now my views dropped, that's not true. You look at my channel, and my channel for the past couple months have been doing really, really well. But if you look before then, I wasn't doing well. I wasn't even uploading, honestly, for a while. They didn't flip a switch. Here's another thing. Some YouTubers are trying to convince their viewers that they have to make 10-minute long videos in order to get into sub boxes. No! What the fuck are you talking about? Every single person I'm sub to on YouTube, their videos make it to my sub box every time I look. Not that I look very often, but if I did look, they'd be there, because the one time I checked, everything was there. Oh, fuck, I gotta turn around. So also, don't believe that shit. I'm here to, if you guys have any questions about that, now I don't know everything. Perhaps longer videos may do better. Maybe there's more engagement because they're commenting multiple times, whatever. But they sure as hell didn't make it so that if you don't make it a 10-minute video, you're not gonna get subboxed or whatever the fuck they call it. That's not true. That's simply not true. But what liking a video does is, apparently there was an update to YouTube, and I talked about this once at the end of one of my videos. They did this thing where they only show highlights. If you sub to a channel, by default, they will only show highlights, and that's, once again, in air quotes, from that user. So if I upload like 8 videos in a day, it's supposed to only show you like my best ones. So the ones that have the most likes or most views or most comments or whatever. So that's what liking a video does. So if people have that selected to only show highlights, then, you know, those videos do better. And if nobody likes a video that I make, then I'm not gonna make the video again. You feel me, dog? Eat a dick. I don't know where to shoot. I'm just gonna run. You don't deserve to have a sniper, you fucking juggernaut bitch. I hope that kills you. Okay, I'm getting you. I'm getting you with that. And that. And that. So, you know, especially when I'm bringing something back like this, it's crucial to see like some sort of feedback, because a lot of people click on a video, get no scoped. They click on a video and that's it, and they might watch it, not comment, not like it, nothing, and that's fine. You know, that's how I am normally when I watch videos. But I don't watch many people. Maybe that's bad. Maybe I'm a bad person. But it definitely helps a little bit in terms of like knowing what to do next, what's your next step. So, you know, you can do that if you enjoy my videos, or if you want to see more live commentaries, or maybe you want one, you know, you want two a week or something. Well, let me know. Like, people think that I'm like some crazy different person now because I uploaded Pokemon Go videos. Newsflash. I'm still me, bro. I'm still me. Fuck you, Freeland. But I need some feedback. Feedback always is helpful, especially with YouTube. Oh, my fantasy team's doing a little bit better. Playing Sarah this week in fantasy, and it wasn't a good week. Michael Thomas is doing well for me, though. Every week, I don't know how many guys play fantasy football. But I'm doing... I did a $50 league with a healthy mix of my friends from high school and college, and then Sarah, and then followers and stuff and friends on Twitter. And right now I'm playing Sarah, and I'm second place in our league. But every week I have this dilemma. I've got Russell Wilson and I've got Marcus Mariota, and I never know what to do. I never know who to start. They're always projected similar stats. You know, Tampa Bay's pass defense is awful, so I started Russell Wilson this week. And Mariota's having a pretty good day against Chicago. So I can never win. I can never win. Last week was awful for me because I had Melvin Gordon, Devontae Booker, Julio Jones, and somebody else on a bye week. My team did awful. I lost, obviously. Hold up 1 second. Okay, we're back. We're going to play one more game. So District will be our last game, and I have to, because Sarah's going to be streaming after this is done. And that's the hard part about only like having both of our setups in one room, is that like only one of us can be working at the same time. Like, I can't sit here and record a live commentary while she's streaming in the background with music and yelling at people and whatever. So we're going to play another one. District I'm actually pretty good at, so this could be interesting. Hopefully. Domination. Hopefully. Oh, Lord, that was a lot of talk. I just talked nonstop for like a half hour. 40 minutes, actually. More than 40. Normally, the ideal length for something like this is like somewhere between 30 and 45. This is going to go a little bit too long, and that's fine. I'll get over it. Hopefully, you guys will too. I feel like people probably fall asleep after 40 minutes. God damn. I'm afraid they're going to pull up right in front of me. Oh, look at that timing. Ready for this? Oh. Flawless gameplay right now. We are playing absolutely as perfect as possible. No! I got fucked. You're a bitch. Don't use Juggernaut. If you have this game, please do not use Juggernaut. There's no reason for it. People hate you. People will hate you. Don't do it. Please. Come around that corner, baby. Oh, I don't believe that. I disagree. I got that kill. Now, if there's... I honestly don't know yet. I haven't decided if I was going to put music in the background of this video. So there might be some quiet music in the background. If you guys prefer either louder music or no music or something, because I'm going to bring this series back. And until All or Nothing's in public matches, it'll probably be a similar format to this one. Modern Warfare Remastered, sniping. Because I'm honestly, like, I do better sniping than I do red gunning. Like, most games, I'll finish on the top of my team. And most people, when they try to snipe, they're like, okay, well, I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna give it a shot. And they go, like, 14 and 27. I normally don't play like that. So, and this is a pretty good game. How did I not? What? This is a pretty good game to snipe. So, if you haven't tried it, get this game and start sniping. And also, a quick reminder, once again, if you haven't done so, follow me on Twitch, because I'm always playing with viewers. So if you ever want to be part of my... Oh, my lord. Oh, I don't deserve the life after that one. So I'm always looking for like a full team to play Search with and go on a winning streak, or at least attempt to. So if you have the game, follow me on Twitch, and you'll be notified whenever I go live, and then we can play together, and we can do some cool things. How about that, too? Oh my god, Chuck, you are a fucking lord. Oh, he's on top of here. I don't know why anybody would want to sit up there. What an awful spot. I need a chopper. Let's get a chopper. No more enemies. Where are my enemies? I'm telling you, I'm always like just one kill short of a clip. One kill short of a clip. They're all gonna spawn over here now. Hey, where, Chuck, you fucking moron. They know where I am. This is dangerous. Or maybe not. Where the fuck? Oh, he went where I was. What a little bitch. That's alright. We do have a chopper, though. Let's call that bad boy in. I told you why are you shooting at me? Oh, there was an enemy. Never mind. Hey, friend. Come on. Give me someone to kill. Give me someone to kill. You're shit. Nice job picking up my weapon. Eat a dick. Oh my. Oh my. Oh my. Oh, Lord have mercy on their soul. Oh, shit. That was too fun. You can't kill me. You can't kill me. Oh, I'm not putting the helicopter up. Not putting it up. 8 more points until this round's over. So let's be patient. Let's wait it out. Do they have a UAV? Oh fuck, I'm not gonna be able to get him. On an 8 kill streak. I'm pretty sure in this game they've reset after a round's over though. Which is unfortunate. Because I was feeling it. Alright, how's the fantasy team doing now? I'm projected to win by 22. Now by 15. So her team's kicking ass. She's got Drew Brees. I hate playing against Drew Brees in fantasy football. I hate it. Every time. Every time I play against him, he goes off. Drops 40 points. Oh, no. Okay, can I get one? Oh, Lord, Chuck. Go on. All right. I'm going to need some help here. I'm going to try and go through. Nope. Thank God you're bad. Alright, we're getting a nuke, boys. We're on a 12 streak right now. Let's get that nuke. If I can go up here, kill him across the way. I'm gonna get for jumping. Moran. Ya moran. Oh, come on! I'm in a dangerous spot here. Does that mean they're not back here? Why did I fucking do that? I didn't even try to knife, I swear. I swear I did. I tried scoping in, but sometimes my fingers get all seizure-y and start doing their own thing. And that's what happened there. Hey, friend. Oh my! Yeah, pick up my gun so you can... That could have been a good feed there. They're all waiting. I shouldn't have waited so long on that first guy, but I wanted to get the guaranteed kill. Will that get over? Probably not. This will, though. So will that! Come on, baby. Don't tease me. Don't tease me. Come on. Thank you. Thank you. Fuck that pole. Nah, see, that's bullshit. Because I'm bobbing and weaving. I'm going around that corner, and you somehow just bend your bullet. I'm not a fan of bending bullets. 37 and 10. Could be better, could be worse. Eh, we'll try and wrap. Let's try to get to 50 this game. I think we can get 50. They're probably very occupied looking over here. So I think if I play this well. Oh shit. I didn't play it well. I was gonna say I could sneak up behind all of them, but then I missed a bullet. You literally, the most frustrating thing in Call of Duty is when you sneak up behind like 8 enemies and you're like, oh my god, I'm about to get like the best clip of my life, and then you just like spray one bullet into each of them and just die. I'm gonna go get this guy. I'm gonna go get him. Get him. Yeah! You can't kill me, man! You can only have to contain me! I don't know what that was. But let's get another chopper. There we go, baby! Let's fucking go! Eat a dick! Not done yet. No! Yeah! I don't have any ammo. I feel bad for these guys. They're getting their asses right. That's a fuck! I'd like to get a nuke. I would like a nuke here. Securing C. Nope. What did we just end on? Was that a 20 kill streak? Jesus. Holy macaroni. That was probably the best sniping I've ever done on this game, on Modern Warfare Remastered. 57 and 11, and we almost got the nuke. We almost got a 25 kill streak. I could have gotten it had I kept playing, believe me. I actually had more kills than the entire enemy team combined, but let's not get into that. I love you guys. I'm gonna call it a live com right now. We are done. Oh my god, shipment! I can't do it. Sorry. So thank you guys very much, everybody, for watching, for listening. I feel like these videos are basically like podcasts. Like, you're probably here to listen rather than watch. But now that you know that I'm capable of such beauty, now you're going to start watching. So I love you guys. Make sure to hit the like button. Now, I don't know how well this video is going to do. So if it's sitting here and it's looking pathetic, it's got 400 likes after 4 weeks, get it to 401. If we can get to 1,000 likes today on Sunday, that would be dope. Thank you very much, everybody, for watching. If you are somehow new here and you watched a 54-minute video before subscribing, you should probably sub just to make yourself feel better. That's my only advice to you. Go Pack, go. Monday night's going to be tough. I'm going to make a prediction here for the Monday Night Football game. Packers are going to... Oh, man. I don't even... Okay, let's say 31-28, Packers win. Last second field goal. Boom. Take it easy, guys. I love you. Peace.